Hi, I'm Palab. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. Understanding demand elasticity is a crucial concept in microeconomics since it has profound implications for both firms and buyers. In this video, we'll go over what demand elasticity is, what it looks like graphically, and factors that can affect demand elasticity. Demand elasticity measures the sensitivity of the quantity demanded of a product to a variable, typically price. For example, if consumers are very sensitive to a price increase of a certain product and buy less of it, the product is said to be price elastic. Conversely, if demand of a good does not change much, even the changes in price, the product is said to be inelastic. Economists can quantify these changes with this formula. Demand elasticity equals the percentage change of quantity demanded divided by the percentage change in price. Graphically, elasticity can be seen as a line shown here with the price levels as the y-axis and the quantity demanded as the x-axis. For a typical good, as price decreases for a good, the quantity demanded increases as seen with the movement from A to B. Many goods and services fall into this category. When a good is perfectly demand inelastic, its quantity demanded does not change even with a small change in price. An example of an inelastic good could be a new life-saving drug only made by one producer from the perspective of a person who would benefit from it. Their consumption would not change with a change in price. Can you think of examples of goods that are inelastic? For a good that is infinitely elastic, its quantity demand is infinite for a given price. There are few real-life examples of such goods, but the theoretical principle is important to understanding other microeconomic ideas. One example of infinitely elastic goods can be found in the luxury sector. A diamond necklace, for example, could always be in high demand no matter what it is priced at. Demand elasticity can be affected by a number of factors. Typically, economists focus on substitution, necessity, prior or current consumption at the time of price change. Substitution refers to how closely a good can be swapped with a similar product. The more easily substituted a good is, the more elastic it tends to be. Think of a highly competitive market like canned soups. Since many of them are highly substitutable, there tends to be more demand for soups that are lower in price, all things being equal. Sometimes, the demand of one good is dependent on the price of close substitutes. The concept is called the cross-price demand elasticity. Necessity is another factor in determining a good's elasticity. The more necessary a good is, the more price inelastic it becomes. A good example of this, as stated before, could be a unique life-saving drug only produced by one firm. The drug can be considered highly price inelastic for those who need it. Share of consumption basket. The amount of goods a consumer owns can also affect the price elasticity to purchase another one. Take a smartphone, for example. For most people, one smartphone is enough to satisfy their daily usage. Therefore, even if the price of a second smartphone was significantly lower than the first, a consumer still may not buy it since their demand function is already satisfied with one smartphone. Finally, time can be a factor for price elasticity. Consumers tend to be elastic over the long term but inelastic on the short term. For example, for commuters used to driving, a short-term increase in gas prices may not change their commuting behaviors. However, over the long run, if the price of driving continues to be expensive, the same commuter may change their mode of transportation to a less costly alternative. If you want to learn more about this, come visit us at Chegg, where you can see solutions that we have already worked out, or ask for help directly from one of the Chegg subject matter experts.